quick little sidetrack before we get into the main video today. But did anyone else just find Kanye West's new album just absolute load of garbage? Holy crap. That has to be maybe the most rushed album ever. Jesus Christ is not king. Especially on that thing. Fuck me. Oh. Like, the first track he was actually on. Where was his vocals? I have more power in my vocals right now. And I'm not even, like, rapping or anything like that. Oh my god, it was so rubbish. Today's video is going to be something slightly different to what I normally do on my channel. I was originally going to be doing an old school video response, throwing it back to like 2009, all the way back when, you know, YouTube was humble and video responses were a thing. I had discovered through my friend Tasha quite an interesting music critic, and occasionally every now and then his videos pop up on my recommended sort of section on my phone or for my second channel. And originally I thought he was doing a bit for his reviews, but it turns out he's just an asshole. And he dropped a video where he was like, I agree, rap music isn't music. And I was like, sorry? Who? What? It's 2019, right? Rap music isn't music? Huh? But then, like, 3 days later, after everyone went shit crazy at him in his comments, he made a second video where he was like, whoops, I was wrong. So, kind of fucked me over on that video. Now, if you follow me on the Twitter... Why did I start that like I was a 80s rap person? I went to the hat store today and I bought myself a hat. Now, if you follow me on the Twitter, you'd know that I am quite the fan of a particular TV show called Atypical. It's a Netflix original TV show set in America about a family who have a high-functioning autistic child. It's pretty good. He's like... how old is he? He's just gone into college in the third season, so he's like 18. So it's, you know, it's like his life from like 17 to 18, how like the parents deal with their lives with him being that, and they have their own family issues, and the daughter, his sister, and how she's kind of like a little bit mean to him, but it's mean with love. It's mean with love, like any sibling normally would be. If you know my friend Connor Ward, I'll stick a thing there to him or down there. You know, he's quite an opinionated human being on the TV show, which is quite fair. Season one was like, season two was like, yeah. Season three is like, oh. All right, and season three is the season that has just dropped. At the end of season two, they decided to slide in a secondary storyline with Sam's sister, Casey. Sam being the main protagonist, Casey being his sister. Casey, just as a bit of background to that character, she's a bit of a jock girl. She's into her track and field. She got coached to the peak of her high school, and then a posh private school was like, we want you to run for us. And she went to this private school, and she... battling with going from public to private school, and then she gets like this group of friends, and they're mean to her, apart from this one girl who's like, oh hey. And basically it starts off the storyline for her in season three, which is coming to terms with her sexuality, which is, you know, it's it's a tough subject to do in the medium of TV, and quite frankly, nearly every TV show and movie I've seen that's discussed bisexuality or come to terms with bisexuality have really fucked it up. Like, horrifically fucked it up. First of all, where's the male representation of bisexuality within cinema and TV? There just is none. Bisexual boys do exist. Hi. And in most films and TVs, they seem to try and make it like, ooh, bisexuality. Look at them. They're sexy. And quite frankly, it's really weird that they do that. That there is no need for them to do that. Humans are generally sexy for just being themselves, aren't they? Does bisexuality suddenly then make you sexier? Because if it does, why am I so lonely? But Atypical actually kind of, I don't know, they kind of did the bisexuality storyline quite a bit of justice, actually, because it wasn't a thing of coming to terms with bisexuality by just boning every human that they see. Boning. It was a storyline that had showed quite a lot of internal sort of like thoughts and struggles and trying to go backwards and forwards, because during this time Casey actually has a boyfriend who's like, you know, this pretty cool dude. He's great with Sam, he's like chill, he's like a general sort of like Midwestern small town sort of like, I'm a dude. But then, you know, this private school girl who's like, oh hey, they start having feelings, and yeah. So it gets a little bit complicated for Casey, and the way that they sort of, the show never tried to make a big sort of fuss over it. I thought it was done quite nicely and quite well. I think if cinema wants to have a look on how to discuss coming to terms with bisexuality, I think Atypical is a pretty good one to sort of look at. Because let's be honest, it's coming to terms with sexuality is not well, in my experience and to what I discover of talking to other people about their experiences, it's generally not a lot of going around and experimenting like, you know, universities and colleges sort of the myth around them it's not like that, really. It's a lot of internal struggles, fights internally, unfortunately putting those out towards other people because you just don't know what to do, and a lot of incognito googling if you get what I mean. The moments of sort of the pressure of coming out, which was really interesting. I mean, they touched quite a bit on the fact that, obviously, you know, it's hard to talk about sexuality and being open about your sexuality in public. And Izzy, the girl that Casey falls for, keeps telling her that she's not ready to come out publicly. She doesn't want to be affectionate in public with Casey. Obviously, that knocks Casey's confidence quite a bit because, you know, she's just come to terms. She wants to express herself. But then, you know, Izzy's a bit of a bitch about it because she ends up, they end up at this party, and Casey goes to make a move. And Izzy goes, no. I don't want my public, my personal life being out in public. And then Izzy goes off and makes out with a dude, which is totes orcs and a real dick move Izzy, real dick move. And then, like, Casey's angry with her, which is completely justifiable. And then Izzy makes some grand gesture by making out with her at school. It's... I think they could have maybe dealt with that a little bit differently. Because, like, after she did that, Casey was like, oh, it's okay. Like, I forgive you. I would have been like, bitch, you're still dead to me. And the way they dealt with that section of the storyline was generally disappointing. Because, I mean, like, Casey doesn't actually come out during this time. She's just trying to, you know, be with her lady. And... They kind of make it sort of this very cheesy, badly, sort of very lazily written way of ending that storyline of the conflict. Which, to be honest, that I don't think I could at this present time recommend any other kind of way you could end that other than pushing it more into the next season, which I do hope that there is a season for. I haven't seen an announcement yet, but you know, there's quite a bit of storylines that, you know, can carry on. I mean, we've only just got Sam at college, which is university for us, us Brits. So I am looking forward to the next season, seeing where they continue on with the bisexual storyline. Just don't lazily write her coming out, because otherwise you did yourself a massive injustice considering how you dealt with the coming to terms. Because I thought that was pretty good. I thought that was very well written and thought about, because it seems like a lot of bisexual storylines within movies and TV in general picture is very lazily written and very bad. But this was pretty good. I give you an A for that. I give you an F for the coming out of Izzy, because no, that's not a thing. If anything, people are more likely to make some sort of coming out video on YouTube these days rather than sort of make out with someone mid school. It's just a bit silly, isn't it? It's a bit silly. Quick side note, though, for what I want to see in season 4, though, of Atypical, if there is a season 4, what happened to the other Sam? You know, dorm room Sam. He was there. He seemed to handle autistic Sam very well, and then you never saw him again. Like, I know Sam didn't, like, stay in the dorms. There isn't much you can explore with that. But he did just kind of pop up, then disappear. And I thought there was a bit of a bro situation going to go on there. Sam could have found his university bro, his college bro. Sam could have been a bro. And also, it would have been pretty cool to see a main storyline of how someone who doesn't necessarily in everyday life experience someone with autism go through the experience of dealing with somebody who has autism and learning how to live with them. Yeah, what happened to other Sam? That's the main question, I think, that should be answered in season 4. What happened to other Sam? He gave him back his jumper because main Sam forgot his jumper. But then what happened? Other Sam just disappears. What happens to other Sam? Hashtag find Lacrosse Sam. Hashtag who killed Lacrosse Sam. Hashtag... save Lacrosse Sam. Hashtag dorm buddies. Don't know why I've decided to go off on this hashtag tangent. I'm going to end the video now, I think.